On the first day, we had overviewed the importance of Moodle and how Moodle has what Moodle has to do and how to start with. Dr. Sajan had taken us in depth into how to start with Moodle. And now, on the second day, he has introduced us to small tweaks that a teacher would ask. And today is the third day. Martiopoulos Training College is in Trivandrum, Kerala. We have it and this being the third program that we had started, the third webinar that we had started after the COVID. And with your participation and with your goodwill, we are running the program good. So on the third day, let me welcome you all to the program, and I hand over to Dr. Sajan for a wonderful session. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Good afternoon to all. I think this is the last day of the workshop. Actually, it is a workshop mode, you know. And today, I request Ansi Madam to share one video with you. It may be with you in your WhatsApp group. And last day, one of the participants insisted me to explain how to create a video so as to upload the Moodle platform. Okay. Actually, as per our today's program, in day three, actually only this much area is there. Online assessment tools, Kahoot quizzes, Google Form, blogging, Blogger, Tumblr, WordPress, bookmarking tools, Wakelet, and Linktree. But I add this topic too because of this reason. I would like to share one video with you, but I don't know its sound is audible there or not. If anyone already watched the video, may have an idea that the topic is Mann-Whitney U-test.
Hi, friends. You know, today we can deal with a new topic, and its name is Mann-Whitney U-test. We can learn different aspects of Mann-Whitney U-test in this presentation, right? And what are the conditions for this Mann-Whitney U-test? We need two categorical variables. Okay, and
I think this much enough. A 3-minute video is there, and it is already shared. How to create this video? I take around 15 minutes to create this video and its PowerPoint. It's a topic for on Monday. I have to handle in my college. It is so simple to use some tools to create these videos. For that purpose, we need either a tool like OBS Studio, otherwise another tool or Screencast-O-Matic. These two tools are suitable for computer, desktop or laptop, and X Recorder or DU Recorder, ADV Screen Recorder, AZ Screen Recorder, like recorders, may be suitable for Android phones. In iPhone, there is an inbuilt screen recorder. Using these tools, I used to create the video, which is already displayed. What is the procedure behind it? The best one is Open Broadcasting Software, OBS Studio, because It is filled with so many tools, but as the layout is somewhat complex, if you are little techie, if you are not little techie, just go for screen customatic. Otherwise, if you are familiar with the procedure of screen recording and all, you can go for OBS Studio. First, I will demonstrate the steps of OBS Studio. Then I can go for the other one. Here, OBS Studio is freely available from internet. Based on your configuration of the laptop, you have to install it. Now, I think you can watch the screen of the OBS Studio. This is the screen of OBS Studio. Here, the first segment, this is the starting stage of OBS Studio. In the first box, you need not to change anything to start work. And this same application can be used to create YouTube or Facebook live streaming. But I do not go for that. I just explain how I created that particular video, which is to be used for tomorrow's class in my college. And the procedure is that I add in the second window. Here, actually, there is no tools. I have to remove these tools.
So we can, what? Hello?
Hello?
Sir?
Yeah.
You can't see the screen. We can't see the screen.
Please pin the screen. I think someone start sharing their screen. That is the reason.
We can't see now.
Dr. Sister Smita Rose CG is also sharing. Parul Baishia is presenting. And that is the defect. Some participants tried to present their screen. Is it visible now?
No, not yet.
Now?
Yes, sir. Now it's visible.
Yeah.
No, sir.
Yeah, please, participants, go to the list of participants in which there are three names with my. There are three windows with my name. Please pin one of the window. In my mobile, I can access this
okay,
screen.
Okay, sir. Okay. Now it's okay.
Okay. Right.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Right. This is the structure of OBS Studio. In order to demonstrate, I have to remove these tools from here. One tool is removed. The other is again removed. Yes, and one more tool to remove. Yes, all tools are removed. And this is the usual structure of the OBS Studio in the first installation stage. Do not make any change here. Okay. Just click on the second box with this plus mark. I request participants not to present their screen. Okay. Now again, it is visible. I request participants to turn on auto rotation in your mobile and put the mobile in landscape position. Then you can watch the screen more clearly. Meantime, I may try to increase the zooming option in my laptop if it is possible. Yeah. This is the second area of the screen. Here, this plus mark is important for us. Click on this plus mark and select window capture or display capture. Best one is the display capture. That means this OBS Studio will capture your entire screen. Okay, click on OK. That is the first stage. Then again, the display ratio will be displayed. Then capture cursor should be ticked. Otherwise, our mouse will not be captured. Mouse pointer will not be captured. Then click OK. One second. Okay. Right.
Sir, could you please repeat it?
Yes. Here in the second window, click on the plus mark and select display capture and click OK. That is the first step. The second step, click on the plus mark and click on video capture devices. Okay. It is available only in desktop, not in desktop, only in laptop. Because in desktop, usually additional web camera is not attached. If you like to use this feature in desktop computers, you have to attach an additional web camera. Then only you can use this. In laptop, usually a web camera is attached on the monitor itself. So just click OK. Then our video will be activated. Just click OK. Here my video is actually used by my Google Meet. So it is not working right now. I have to switch off and come back. I will try to open. Usually it is possible to open both camera in both application. Here, video capture device. Yeah, now it is okay. You can watch my face here. That means OBS Studio now capture my face. Now click OK. It will be displayed over the screen. You can click and drag. Usually it is best to place it in the, on the top, sorry, bottom right corner. And you can adjust the size of our body with the screen. This is the total screen. Okay. This is the second step. Third step, if you have additional microphone attached with the system, you can add that also. Here in this, in my case, there is an additional microphone. So I have to switch it on. USB microphone is there. So I have to add that also. Then here my voice is displayed. Okay. If the system sound should be added to your video, it you have to switch on this icon, desktop audio icon. This should be switched on. Otherwise, the audio from the computer will not be recorded. Now, if you want to record only microphone, this is the button. Now my microphone is turned off. See, there is no moving here. Moving window is not here. So again, I switched it on. Please check which all the microphones or in sound input devices have to be switched on or off based on the moving cursor here. This is the third area of interest. Okay, now this is somewhat enough to start our work. But before going to start recording, I make some changes in this particular window. Okay, this is the window of our interest because we want to remove this blue background into transparent. Then only the students, the audience have a feeling that we are sitting in front of or standing in front of a large PowerPoint projector. For that feeling, I have to remove this blue area. This particular application, that is OBS Studio, can remove only two colors. The best one is blue, in my opinion, but many reviewers suggest that green is best. Okay, in my practical experience, blue is best. For that purpose, I placed a sari, blue sari here. For that purpose, I place it there. Okay, then I click on the video capture device. That is, this is the video capture device. Right click on it and go for filters. Click on filters, and here effect filters are added here by a plus mark on the lower left corner. There is a plus mark. In order to add that filter, I right click here, right click, add chroma key. This is the particular application of this OBS Studio which make that effect. Chroma key, select chroma key. Here what is the defect is that my dress is also blue and the background is blue, then it will not work properly because only my head and skin color will be displayed. My shirt will not be displayed on the screen. So in order to make me visible altogether, I have to make another dress for me. Okay, is it clear? I have to change my dress in order to demonstrate fully. But yet I try to demonstrate. Click OK. Usually the green is the default color here. I change the color into blue. Then what happened? Now only my body and skin will be displayed. My shirt is in black color. This black color and this black color background will become transparent. Okay, that is not good with this blue shirt. So I have to change the shirt, then only I can demonstrate fully. Please wait 1 second. Yeah, now I think it is enough. This brown color is suitable for this background. Then for my convenience only, I made one more change that I made one more correction here. That is only for my convenience. Usually I am a right-hander, but while sitting on the right side of the laptop, it is convenient to use this mouse, but many can use mouse with the left hand. If you can use left hand, then you can place this window, this our display window, to left side. Okay, then there is no need to adjust, but here it is my position, so I have to adjust this screen again. I click right click and on transform, I make one more change, that is flip horizontal. Horizontal is right? Okay, I think. Yeah. This is the only thing. I make a mirror appearance on the screen. Now I increase my height. Okay, that is comfortable position. This is enough. Now I can start recording a video. How? This is the start recording button. Click start recording button. Now recording is started. Just minimize this window. Then open our PowerPoint file. then click on any PowerPoint file. You can use any PowerPoint file to explain. Here in the first stage, I use this Mann Whitney
website. Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, could you just repeat that transform step after transform?
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Before that, I will switch on the PowerPoint. Okay, here OBS Studio is the, after transforming this, that is, I am on the right end of the screen, and I just start recording from the last menu. From the last menu, there is a button for recording. Usually the screen display recording is in high quality and the recorder file will be in a heavy size. You can reduce the size, such things can be possible from the setting button. I will not demonstrate all those things right now, but you can just click on start recording right now. Start recording. Okay, then minimize this window and open our PowerPoint to explain. This is the only step. Now I made it full screen, but actually now I made one. Can you watch my webcam right now? Can you see my face? No.
No sir. Only screen.
Not only screen.
Face is not seen.
Okay. Now again. No, not possible. Okay, as it is used by OBS Studio, I cannot switch on. Okay, for that purpose, I switch on my one of other mobile phone camera in order to watch me. You just switch on. You can interchange the screen as well as one screen in the participant list. One face is there with my screen. My face is there. You can search for participant list. Now one, my screen is presented. At the same time, there is another window with my camera. Is it right? Hello, is it right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, right. Now I make the screen full screen. And actually what is happening is that I am sitting in front of my laptop, but the capturing is occurred like that I am sitting in front of a large screen. So that screen is actually not presented behind. You please watch the mobile, my mobile web camera. There is a blue background in my backside. In that backside, nothing is there. But I make a change in the while conducting the class that please watch Mann Whitney U test here. In that way, I just turn back and focus on my screen, not on the screen, but on the blue saree, and touch. See, there is two animals are there, a large animal and a small animal. Okay, in that way, in between, turn back to this blue saree and again come back to and observe to the camera. And this is the recording process going on. Meanwhile, I'll explain those things. Then I stop recording right now and I will want to demonstrate what is happening. Now switch off the mobile camera view. Now come back to this OBS Studio. Just click here again to stop recording. I already stopped my recording. Here the same button will be turned to start and stop. I will show it again, but before that, we can go for the recorded video. Recorded video is usually stored in the video folder. In video folder, This is the last file. Based on the time, you can recognize 2020, 620, 1452. That means this is the file of last recording. Just turn it on to watch what is happening though.
Start recording. Okay, then minimize this list. Same time, right? In front of my laptop. See. But the capturing is occurred like that. I am sitting in front of a large screen. So that screen is actually not presented behind. You please watch the mobile. My mobile web camera. There is a blue background in my back side. In that back side, nothing is there. But I make a change in that while conducting the class. That please watch man with me. You test here. In that way, I just turn back and focus on my screen, not on the screen, but on the blue side, and touch. See, there is two animals are there. A large animal and a small animal. Okay, in that way, I in between turn back to this blue sari and again come back to and observe to the camera. And this is the recording process going on. Meanwhile, I explain those things. Then I stop recording right now and I will want to demonstrate what is happening. Now,
I think it is clear for you. What is the process going on? I want a feedback. Okay, right now, some many comments are there in the chat box that they can follow it. Then you experiment with this OBS Studio. This is a fantastic software which help us to create beautiful videos. And if you are not so techie, but you want to create a video like this, not exactly like this, place you in a box inside the presentation. That's all. For that purpose, you can go for this particular application, and its name is Screencast-O-Matic. And it is a web-based recording, so you have to be in online while starting the recording time. And it is a free recorder for 15 minutes. If you want to record more time, you have to purchase it. No need of login, etc., etc. Just click on this start recording for free. Click on this start recording for free. Its name is Screencast-O-Matic. Just click on start recording for free. It will click on launch free recorder. It will download a recorder each time. If you already downloaded it, it may try to download it again because they tried to prevent the hacking of this particular platform. Click on this button and just click on it, click it open. It will select the area like this. A rectangle will appear. And in the last menu, there is an option to select both camera and screen. That's only we need. This is starting up. And you can click and drag this particular rectangle to record a particular area. And you can select the microphone also. Yes, this is updating. Such process are always going on each time while try to record. And the free version allow you to record only 15 minutes. But it is so free, so easy. That's why I suggest this application. But if you are little interested in technology, you please go for OBS Studio. That is best for you. And this is the stage now. This is the square box to drag the click in and record. Click this webcam screen, webcam, and both. Click on both. Please mute the mic, please. Okay, right. Please observe here in this webcam, you may be appear, but it is not so powerful as OBS Studio. That's why this webcam is not working while it is captured using this Google Meet. I tried to switch off the Google Meet camera. It is already switched off, but again the webcam will not be appeared here because this camera is not accessible for the software right now because of using Google Meet. Now do the same thing. Switch on the PowerPoint. Which PowerPoint? Yeah, now it is enough. Then click on the slideshow button. My screen is yet not here. Come here. Okay. Slideshow button. Now in this square box, your face will be appeared. And you can talk to the computer after clicking on this rec button. There is a rec button on the top, bottom left hand side corner. There is a rec button. Click on the rec button. A countdown will be started. 3, 2, 1. Hi friends, today we can explain different things regarding Moodle, Google Classroom, Edmodo, Canvas. In that way you can record the screen, and after recording you can click on the stop button and click on this done button. It will save, it will help you to save the recorded file. Okay, this is the recorded file. If I click here,
hi friends, today we can explain different
why my camera is not there. Only because of the reason that it is used by Google Meet. In that way this application is so simple, and no need to go for further settings, etc., etc., as in OBS Studio. But it is not so powerful to make unlimited time video or to make your background transparent, etc. It's not possible with that application. And the first created video contained many errors in the beginning stage. If you want to correct such defects, you need a application known as video editors. There are number of video editors available. One of the interesting application is Wondershare Filmora 9, but it is costly. You have to purchase it to use, or otherwise you have to crack it. And another one, a free one, open source one, is OpenShot Video Editor. It is freely available from internet, and you can use this application to trim the video. And the first part of the video you have to trim. Okay, then using any of the application, or you can use Kaden Live, one application which is available for Linux, now available for Windows also. This KDENLIVE, Kaden Live. And the Kaden Live is also free for now in Windows, and it is open source. You can use either of the three applications to edit your video if you like, and you can add background music. Such things are possible, but it is not get time to demonstrate all those things. So I just mentioned the name, either Kaden Live or OpenShot Video Editor, or go for Filmora Go. Filmora 9 is best one, but either you have to purchase it or you have to crack it so as to install in your laptop. Kaden Live is so powerful, so you can go for Kaden Live. Okay, if you like to increase the sound of the presentation, etc. Now I request participants to watch my mobile camera. For that purpose, I stop my presentation. Okay, now my visual is okay, I think. Hello.
Hello.
Okay. See, this is my mobile camera. I want to switch the camera to back. And this is the setup I used. This is a microphone. You can either use this type of a microphone. It is not so costly, 1500 something like that. or you can use these type of microphones which is available with you to record. And this is an ordinary laptop with the Windows I think Core i3. Then you can use this type of a light here. Okay. And this light will help you to get more light on your face, or you can use a table lamp for that purpose. Then this is the arrangement here. A blue sari is kept in the background. This is all only setup I used to create this video and this live communication with you without much defects. Okay, I think now it is. Hello, is it audible?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes.
Okay. It is audible.
Yeah. Can it's you watch my room with my mobile phone?
No.
In the previous session, I demonstrated the room setup using my mobile phone.
That we yes, have sir. That. We will see that,
sir. Yeah, some of them watched it. Some of them not. Again, I will connect the mobile phone. This is okay now. Is it audible now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, audible. Yes.
Can you watch my laptop?
Yeah, but upside down.
Now it is clear?
Now it is okay.
It's okay.
Okay, okay. Yes. Right. This is a microphone I used for recording as well as for this live session. This can be purchased from online with 1500. And this, what is advantage is that this is USB. So not much loss in sound will occur. Otherwise, you can go for a headset-like microphone, which is available usually with any mobile phones. Or you can go for the mic attached to the top side of the laptop screen. Okay. Then a tube light is attached here. An LED tube light is attached to here to give more light on my face. Okay. Then otherwise, you can use a table lamp like this to enlighten. Okay, right? Then I put one blue sari here, or you can use one blue curtain, blue or green, so as to make the transparent effect. These are the only thing I need or I have to make this session live, and it's also used for my recording. The camera on this mobile phone, the laptop is used for recording as well as this live class. Just to familiarize you with what are the physical facilities I used to, or hardwares I used to record. I think except this microphone, all things may be with you. This type of a microphone is not needed, but it will give more clarity in sound. Now, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, right. Yes, sir. Now I again switch back to my laptop. I again start presenting my screen to go for the next topics. I would not like to demonstrate the other video tools for mobile phone because of the lack of time. If you need and get enough time, I can demonstrate later. Now I go for the other topic, that is PDF book flip HTML converter. I think it is not so essential for you. And this is the recorder I used in mobile phone, X recorder. Okay, then online assessment tools. We can go for online assessment tools. It may be quite interesting for an online teaching. And in which there are several tools are there, Kahoot, QSIS, Google Forms, these three. In which QSIS is best for live demonstration of live quiz programs. Then Google Form is used for asynchronous question answer sessions. I think Google Form is more familiar with you. Many of the participants already know. So I skip that. And you just, if you are not familiar with these tools, just write down the name and you can use that name to search. All the answers are there. Yesterday I demonstrated my YouTube channel. Beautiful explanation are there also. Now QSIS, QSIS login. QSIS.com, QUIZIZ.com. This is a login window. Here, if you are first time, don't have an account, click here to sign up. You have to click here. You have to click here and sign up to enter first time. And you will be provided with one password. And using that password, you can log in at any time. This password and this login credential will be sent to your email. Okay. Otherwise, you can log in with the Gmail, but my request, don't go for that. That means this QSIS is permitted to use your Gmail account. So always use another email ID and password to log in. Here in the first window, there is an option to create a new quiz. Click on the button to create a new quiz. You can introduce this platform to your students that this platform helps to search topic without creating anything. You can search for any topic and can play different topics by themselves for practice. Click on practice and they can practice it. So just an account in QSIS help you to learn, your students to learn. Okay, so this name in that way is important. Your students can learn multiple choice questions and they can practice it. Otherwise, you can create a new quiz. Otherwise, you can search for a quiz and play live. I don't know whether this question is right or no. I just selected this, just searched for statistics and selected this game. Instead, I can use my own quiz here. My own quizzes are there. In which one ICT research methodology, one ICT question is there. I would like to use it now. And I click on play live. Click on play live. And this is the platform to start playing the game. Just click on the classic mode. This is more interesting, classic mode with some add-ons like a bonus point will be given to you, such that. Or you can click on the test button. This is more serious examination. The student have to give their original name. They should have an account to play. If you like to use this tool as for assessment, internal assessment, you can use it as a test. But now I play it with classic mode. Then continue. Click on the button, continue. Select classic and click on continue. Now I request the active participant to join my quiz just for a demonstration, not for to assess you, just for a demonstration. Just click on, just type this address, joinmyquiz.com, and give this code 635316. I will give this in the chat box. I request any organizers to give in the YouTube live as well as in the WhatsApp groups. joinmyquiz.com. That is the address, joinmyquiz.com. No need to create any account. Just go for joinmyquiz.com and give this letters 635316. Just give that code. Then we can demonstrate. Yeah, many students join, many participants join first here. See? Yeah. These all are participants now joining. As it is a game mode. No need of your original name, etc. I think 10 participants are there. And now I start my game. Yeah, many are now joining. Okay, I click on start button, a countdown, 5, 3, 2, 1, a countdown is there, then ready, go. Don't try to, don't waste time to read the question and just click any answer, just for a demonstration. Just click any answer. It's just for a demonstration. It is right or wrong. You just click and go fast. See, these participants marking their responses. Do it fast. Do it fast. No need to come first or not something. Here the points are there displayed. Okay. In that way, you can play live manner with your students during your class. If it is in Google Meet or in a Zoom meeting, you can play this game. And this is the advantage of this particular platform. And you can use the question of others, or you can create new questions. In order to create new questions, there is an easy way. That method is known as teleporting. I'll explain teleporting after ending this game. Yeah, I think it is enough. Many of them completed all the 5 questions. Okay, with fully corrected it. Okay, now I end the game. Yeah. I think there are so many tools for. Yeah, here the first position, second position, and third position will be displayed. And you can download all the results if you like. If you like, you can download all the results in an Excel format. You can download the result from here. And you can submit your HODs or principals that you conduct an examination for students, and their mark list is asked. In that way, you can give. Okay, just click on exit button to exit this game. Then what is the advantage is that if you want to create a new quiz, so many other people will help you. For example, I would like to create a test on non-parametric statistics. Non-parametric statistics. My level of class educator professional development. Okay, click on next. This is the steps to create. And whether you use to multiple choice question or checkbox or fill in the blanks, or it is a poll, or it is an open-ended short answer type question, you can select anyone. But if you select open-ended, it will not grade themselves. There is no right answer. All other can be used to create new one. Then click on this, click on multiple choice question. This is my favorite. Then type the question here. Man Whitney, Q test, we say, in that way you type, we say, equivalent of T test, similar to ANOVA. Similar to correlation is enough. Then similar to regression. In order to make same structure, I make similar to. Yeah. This is a step to create, and select the right answer by clicking the here. This is the right answer. I click the here. You can use mathematical symbols as answers as well as questions. You can use audio or images for your questions. Such things are there. You can set a time for each question and click on save. This is the view of this particular question in mobile. Just click save. Yeah, it is saved. And this question is created by me, but I want to add some question from others. For that purpose, I click on this teleport. This is a button to teleport question. So many similar applications will be arrived here. Some similar quizzes will be displayed here, created by anyone, and it is freely available on quizzes. You can select any quiz. For example, statistics. If any question is there with the non-parametric statistics, you can click just add. If it is a question suitable for me, just click add. This question will be added to your question. See, now there are two questions. First question is created by me. Second question is just teleported. But while teleporting question, you should be thorough with the answers and check whether it is right or wrong. Otherwise, your students will think that your question is wrong. Okay, in that way, you can add questions. After adding all the questions, just click on done button. And you can add a custom image for the quiz. You can select the grade for this question, and actually it is for university or professional development level. Just click on this and click on save button. Okay, it is saved. And this non-parametric statistic test is available to play right now. And you can, instead of assigning it as a live game, you can assign as a homework. That means the student can sit in their home at any time. You can set the time here. And this time is one day, even 7 minutes later. Just click continue. This question will be available tomorrow at 3:30 p.m. On Sunday, 3:30 p.m., this question will be available for the students. In that way also, you can set this particular quiz. Almost same structure is for Kahoot, but I think more neat layout is here in Quizzes. So you try any platform, either Quizzes or both. You can try any. There are so many platforms available for this online assessment. Poll everywhere, then one hot potato. In that way, there are so many tools. Nearpod, Slido, Socrative. Okay, but I think it is enough for with this particular tool. But there is a limitation that you cannot add a video in front of your question. And after watching this video, identify the character in the video. In that way, you cannot create a question here. But it is possible in your famous Google form, and I think Google form is somewhat similar familiar for you. I think it is enough for this quizzes. Are there any queries in chat box? Please read. Otherwise, I may skip to this Google form, and thank its you, address sir. Is forms.google.com. This is the best way to go to to create a Google form. forms.google.com. Otherwise, some may suggest that go to Drive, and from the new menu you can use this Google form. Yeah, you can use that way also, but using this particular way, it will give you a number of templates to create questions. Here I just click enter. I already logged in my Google Chrome, so it directly reaches to my Google form area. Here all these are all created forms by me. You can create a new by clicking here, or you can go for the templates. These are the recent templates I used. Otherwise, there is a large template gallery of different types: personal, work, for education. Okay. In that way, there are so many tools. excuse me one second, one important call for me. Okay, sorry for the disturbance right now. This is the platform we can select adequate templates. If you like to use this Google form for assessment, you can use this template. Otherwise, you can directly start from this blank itself. What is advantage is that here in assessment, it is already set all the features for an examination, but you have to remove unwanted things there. So many unwanted questions may be there. You have to remove it. Just click on this assessment. Here you can use it for course evaluation, course registration, similar, many other purposes are there. And this is the assessment platform. Here you can give a name, maths test. Then you can remove these words and you can add, dear students, please read. And in that way, you can type your direction and your name will be, you can add by your teacher, doctor. In that way, you can give some directions here. And this is important aspect for students. They have to give name, so don't change this section. And this also is a good question for them because they have to submit their email. Then quiz questions. Here you can give some descriptions. Otherwise, you can just remove it. For example, quiz question. These quiz questions are from this particular polynomials from the chapter of polynomial. This question is created. In that way, you can add some descriptions. Otherwise, you just remove it. This is the delete button. This is the duplicate button, not these features. And there are three dots here. In these three dots, you can add more descriptions, etc., etc. Okay, this is a section head. This part is a section head. And there is a 9 dots here. In for each section, these 9 dots. Can you see these 9 dots? This is so small in size.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
There's a button. If you click on the 9 dots, its shape will be changed into angle, and then you can drag the question. This is the purpose of this 9 dots. And this is the first question. Here you can create your first question. A plus B all square is equal to like that. In that way, you can type the question. You can add images for your question from by clicking this icon. And here you can give the answer to here you can give the right answer. Five is the right answer. Instead of that question, I will change the question in this way. Okay, it is easy to create. 3 + 2 is equal to 3, 4. Right, now my question is ready. Here, this is the right answer, so you have to tick it. Here in the template is already added and answer key is already there and with 1 point, its score is 1 point. Just click here to see whether it is right or wrong. Then you can increase the score by clicking answer key. Click on answer key. Here you can change. Instead of 1 score, you can give 10 score for 1 question. That is your choice. Okay. then you can change the answer key from here also. If it is the right and it is also the right answer, there are, if there are two right answers, you can use this method, or you can remove this answer and you can add this answer. It is possible. Okay. Now, if you want to add some feedback for incorrect answers, please try again like that. You can have this area to edit. The correct answer is right because of it is right. Here, click on the edit button is needed to edit this because it is right. Click on save button. Okay. Then this feedback will be available for the student. Then the see the second question. Second question is of another type. Third question is a short answer type. Next question is a paragraph type question. No, it's a question based on this paragraph. Based on the paragraph, you can ask some question. In that way, you can create different types of question using the template. Then you can rename this into mass test and save. It is already saved. While creating the test itself, it is already saved in your Google Drive. I once mentioned the Google apps available from this 9 dots. In the 9 dots, Google Drive is here. Inside the Google Drive, this particular question, mass test, is already saved without doing anything. While creating the form itself, it is saved here. So it will not load. Then how to send this question to students? Just click on the send button. There are three ways to send. Okay, either you can email, or you can create a link in this way, or you can select the embed code and you can paste in your blog or website. In these three ways, you can select send the question. Then you can limit the response. You can use this form for certification. After passing this question, you can give some certificate for students. Such things are possible. This is an add-on for certification. And there are so many other settings, like you can change it, not change into quizzes or change into quizzes. Such things are there. If you want to learn more anything regarding the Google form, please ask in the chat box. Otherwise, we can go for the next thing. If any queries regarding this? I think how to set a certificate for the quiz. So simple search for the, please search for an add-on. Okay, button add-on. How to search for add-on? Click on settings, Click on these three dots. In which add-on? There is an option known as add-ons. Click on add-ons and search for certified. That particular add-on is known as certify. Here you can search for certify, or if it is already there, no. Yeah, this is the application, certify. If it is not seen there, here you can search certify. This is the name of this particular. Or you can use Autocrat, another add-on. There are several add-ons for this purpose. Click on certify and install it. This is already installed. Otherwise, you click and install. During installation, it will ask permission to use your email ID and Google Drive. Just give the permission. Without giving permission to this add-on, it is not possible. After installing this add-on, it will appear like this. Then click on this button, certify EM. Click on this. It is not loaded right now. Again, once again, try certify EM. If certify EM is switched on, it will take some time to start. You can click on help it is not started, getting started. Close. I want to just close this window and start it again, because the Certify application is not so buggy free. Daily you can create only 100 certificate with normal email ID. Otherwise, if you have a G Suite account, you can create paid G Suite account, you can create 1500 certificates per day. Now I think it's good. Yeah, enable Certify EM in this case. Click on this button, enable Certify EM in this case. Now it is enabled. Okay, then click on get started. And it will let you to move to a certain area of the application, and it help you to select a particular template for the certificate like that. Here, passing mark is needed 80%. You can change it into 60% or 90%. In that way, you can change. And you can use any certificate template from here. Template means it is by default selected a golden template. You just preview the templates, but it is not so good. Where is the golden? This is the golden template. This certificate declares that this person, in that way. Or if you want to create a certificate of your own, just click here. Not here. It is not the place. I will demonstrate later. These are the default certificate available in Certify. If you select this particular certificate, this is the structure of the certificate. Otherwise, if you want to create your own certificate, there is another way. I will show that. Instead of using this template, click here and select a custom template. In the custom template, you can create your own certificate. This current template is golden. Instead of you can use any other templates. Select a new file. And it will search for all certificate file from your drive, Google Drive. This is a permission it needed. And if there is no such certificate, you can create a new one by giving some codes. All such details are available, how to create a good certificate. And all these are some certificates created by me or some certificates given to me. All are stored there. How to select preview all, not that. You say custom template in which select a new file, not here. Preview all. Yeah, this is the area. If you want to create a new Google Slide document, you can create a new Google Slide document with some details. It is nothing, but you can give any area with some codes, and that code is given within these signs. In that way, you can give the code for this certificate. If I type the username here in small letters, username, it will type the question, the answer of the question, just after the email. In our question, it asks for email. You have to change it into the first question. Email should be the first question. Then the second question will be displayed in the place of username. And this is the code used to create the words. You can type anything there, but never change this code. That's the only thing you have to care about creating a certificate. I think I can break for 15 minutes. Then meanwhile, you can ask any doubts regarding this thing. Otherwise, I can go for another session. Before that, I request participants to type their details, their feedbacks in the comment box, as well as the form given by the organizers. I want to take a small break now in order to give an address by the principal of Mark Theophilus Training College. Thank you.
Thank you, Sergeant sir. Dear participants, we are just on the last day of the seminar. We are not ending things and then going into the faculty section. We'll just start over the smallest possible. Dr. Keva, principal of Mark Theophilus Training College and the general convener of the program, may I request Dr. Keva Benedict.
Good afternoon, dear respected Sergeant Sir, and my dear colleagues and respected participants of this 3 days workshop. Today we are coming to a closing part of the session, but actually I think that this 3 days was not sufficient to deal in depth with all these different items. But anyway, the expertise of and the correspond the excellent presentation by Dr. Sergeant Sir made a mesmerizing effect on all the participants, including the organizers. And that's why there is a huge rush. Yesterday and today, we were fortunate enough to have more participants on online with a G Suite possibility. And the majority of the registered participants are viewing it by our YouTube presentation. Hope that our companionship becomes a great effort in our transition period of converting all the direct classroom experience to an online one, so that after the COVID-19 impact, we may be able to club together the direct as well as the online medium, so that a blended learning experience could be provided. For the last many years, we have been speaking and lecturing on all these things, but this is the current moment that we made ourselves to learn a good number of things. I feel that the presence of Dr. Sergeant Sir and his service has made this 3-day workshop a grand success. And on behalf of all those who are assembled here, I congratulate Dr. Sergeant Sir, who is a close friend of mine for the last 2 decades. Hope that we may meet at a time, person to person, so that we will organize live workshops more for our teachers all around the country. Thank you very much for the organizers, particularly that of Dr. Ansi AS and Dr. Laji Varghese for making the technical arrangements and other coordinating work regarding the communication between the participants, then the other physical restructuring. Dr. Laji was successful day before yesterday to establish the link with the G Suite, so that we accommodated more participants day yesterday and today. So other college, we have the participants list, more than 1,000 participants registered for this program. We hope that we may keep in touch in many ways in future similar endeavors. Thank you very much. So I hope that convey to your principals and managers and other organizers of your institutions regarding the wishes that we convey from Mark Theophilus Training College, Trivandrum, which was one of the pioneering teacher education institution, the fourth teacher education college in the Kerala state, and the first co-ed teacher education in the Kerala state. So I convey all the best wishes for your workshop experience. Hope that you have enjoyed a lot, learned a lot, and you experienced a kind of partial paradigm shift in your perception. And that seems to be the most rewarding gift that we have received from this workshop. I congratulate each and everyone for your presence and patient participation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words. We are now, we just have the feedback sheet being uploaded. Just a couple of things. I know that the feedback sheets have been sent, and you really have to put in the feedback as well as the attendance. See, this is just to keep things in place and order. I request the participants not to feel bad. This is just that we have the pleasure of doing something right and doing something good, doing something the way teachers should do it. So I hope you would understand. The workshop also demanded some homework to be done. Dr. Sajan has been very supportive. He had given us all support. He had given us all the instruction to provide the homework assignments. And he had also actually supported the participants in doing the assignments also. So we all actually enjoyed being here doing this. Even today evening, Sajan sir had promised that we'll give some assignments which can be submitted later today evening. Along with all these things, we just need a second chance would be given. So if you haven't submitted your assignment today, don't worry. At the end of the day, with the link in the feedback, you will be given a chance to resubmit all your assignments. So not to worry about assignments, not to worry about assignment that you're going to have today evening. The assignments are not important. What is important is that you are able to do to go away from this session with a practical ability to do things. So with these words, I thank each and every participant. Thanks to my fellow convener, ANSI, my dear colleagues in Mar Theophilus Training College, to Dr. K.Y. Benedict for all the support. Last but not the least, and to the greatest, to Sajan sir. I pass on to Sajan sir for the rest of the session. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir. I think now we can continue with the session. If there are no much queries in the chat box, there are so many videos available in YouTube, my YouTube channel, regarding certification and the process using different applications like Certify and as well as Autocrat. So now I switch on to the next topic, that is the asynchronous platforms for our online learning. Asynchronous platform means a personal website for each teachers. We know that we already have Google Classroom or Edmodo or Moodle to transact with the students, but these are closed platforms. It means only my students can access my Google Classroom, my student can access my Edmodo, my student can access my Moodle. But I would like to demonstrate many of the materials for the benefit of other students in other colleges. If you like to share such materials, you can use different platforms like Blogger, Tumblr, WordPress, bookmarking sites, etc., and Google sites, etc. And you can create free websites using these platforms, and it will not cost anything. But what is the benefit for the learning community is that your blog or your website will be beneficial for their learning. For that purpose, the easiest platform to create a beautiful blog is Blogger itself, Blogger, Blogger itself. I will demonstrate some of the good blogs. One of the famous blog in Kerala is Mass Blog. It is created by a group of school teachers for the benefit of other school teachers as well as students, not only in Mass but also for all other subjects. Many things regarding the school teachers' problems, their service area, the students addressing matters, question papers, many things is posted here in this blog, and it is created not by a single teacher but collaboratively by a group of teachers. And this is the advantage of this platform blog. You can customize the platform in many ways. You can collaborate with the other teachers. You can add any number of pages, any number of materials. To create this blog, you need only one thing, that is a Gmail ID and its password. That's all we need. And this is a good example. Hello, is it audible now?
Yes, sir. You're audible, sir.
That is one of the example of a famous blog. Another good example is I proudly say that in my college the website is given by a local team, and its address is nsse.org, but the space for this platform is very less. Okay, so we cannot add all those things happened in my college in this particular website because of the lack of space limit. So we do one thing is that we create a blog and attach the blog here. In events bar links, I attached my blog, and the address of the blog is NSS Training College blogspot.com. This is the address. Right now its address is somewhat changed into blogspot.com, and this is the blog here. Here you can see that starting from 2013. Hello.
So your screen is not visible, sir. Have you started sharing it?
Yeah, it's already started, but I think. Now is this visible, I think?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. In order to create a beautiful blog, the easiest way to go to blogger.com. Okay. One of the famous blog is Mass Blog. In the Mass Blog, you can see a number of things suitable for Kerala school students and teachers, school teachers, their service matters. And it is collaboratively created. Similarly, in my college, the web space is very low. So it is created by a local agent, and we do not spend much money on this website. But we do one thing is that we have created a blog and added here. And the blog is here, and this is the blog. In this blog, we added all those things. All those things happened in our college, IQAC, magazines, different clubs, committees, calendar, syllabus, all those things are here, can be dumped into this blog because it is unlimited space. And starting from 2013, all the events can be digitally recorded. Here, all the events, in 2014, the magazine's name is Yanam, and still it is available on here. It's digitally digital plan. In 2014, the magazine is still here. Okay, this is the thing, and each day we can develop this blog. And who create this blog or who develop this blog, and all the teachers, all the faculties in the blog in the college are the collaborators of this blog. So they can create a new post and can add materials. In that way, if in the time of NAC or IQC, any time, all the materials can be collected from this site. That is advantage. Okay. One second. And this is advantage of this blog. And then how to create? We already know that creation of blog is there in our B.Ed curriculum for years, and we teach creating blog. But yet we, I think we much not explore the functions of the blog. And that's why after hearing the name several times, we may have an adverse effect regarding this particular concept blog. But there are so many other platforms like WordPress.com. Or sites.google.com, Google Sites. Or you can go for Tumblr.com. All these sites do the somewhat the same thing, but the fantastic area is Blogger itself. I compare all these platforms. In Tumblr, you cannot make much change in the layout, but the space is unlimited. But the advantage is that you can post from the mobile very easily. Its mobile application is so simple. That is the advantage of Tumblr. An application is available from Play Store to create blogs with the help of Tumblr. And what is the advantage of site is that you can directly attach files, PowerPoint files, PDF files, etc. to this blog, to these sites. But the disadvantage is that the site address is not so easy. This is the somewhat the address, sites.google.com/new/. In that way, its name is not so good. And other thing is that it consumes your Google Drive space. It is created within the Google Drive. So your 15 GB is the limit of a Google site. And the WordPress. Regarding the advantage of WordPress is that once you like to convert your blog into a website, it is a paid website. It is so easy. Just paying the money, it will automatically convert it into the good with a good domain name to a professional website. Such a conversion is easy in the case of WordPress, but the free WordPress will give only you 2 GB. Okay. But in the case of Blogger, its space is unlimited. And there are some fantastic themes are also there, but you cannot convert all these things in a single click into a website. This address itself considered as a website, then it's good. nsstrainingcollege.blogspot.com. If you are good with this name, that's enough. Otherwise, you can attach nsse.org is the domain name. You can attach your blog somewhere else. In that way, you can satisfy with the help of blog. Then we can go for the steps in the creation of blog, not the creation of the blog, but the advanced settings in the blog. Here in blogger.com, one second, it will directly log in into one of my page. Yeah, here itself, in the college blog itself, it reached. See, in yesterday, February 19th, yeah, yesterday there is something happened there, and it is added by one teacher here. She is in charge of that particular activity. She added there, then it will be automatically published to the website. She done it with the help of her mobile. Okay, and this is another thing happened on 18th June, and that is posted by another teacher. Yeah, is added by another teacher. In that way, any teacher can contribute to this blog, and the administrator or admin of this blog have to do only one thing. If it such images maybe go out beyond the area, you just drag it into a small area. In that way, you have to make some changes while getting some time. You can modify this such changes. Now go for this creation of the blog step. In a single email ID, you can create 100 blogs. 100 blogs per email ID. That means you can create a number of blogs. So don't worry about creation of a wrong blog. Do you want to delete it? Don't worry about it. Create a new one. That's all. Then I will demonstrate one blog here. Yeah, for one blog, it is created for one purpose, and it is there. Okay. Do you want to learn the creation step? I think it is so easy and familiar with all teacher educators. Creation of a new blog is so simple. But the advanced things like collaboration, adding collaboration, changing layout, adding tabs like this. There are many tabs. I think these are the good features you like to know. Then I will focus only that area. Here, yesterday I shared one blog address with you, technosaji.blogspot.com, in which I added another theme. Based on the theme, the appearance may be different. Here also you can add several tabs. Here, home, all videos, YouTube channel, such things can be added. Then, but the layout is different. Here in college blog, its view is different. See, its view is different. Themes are available in a blog. And now we can customize one blog for you. Again, it is, I think, GCT test blog. I can use this particular blog. Here, in this blog, I will demonstrate what are the things we have to change. Here, this is the area where you can add a new post. While creating a post, there are many possibilities. For all area, we have to give it heading. Test during webinar. MTTC. Okay, that is a heading I used here. Then this is the area we can type. Using mobile phone, you can type manually, or you can use voice typing. You can type in Malayalam. All things are possible. And after typing the matter, you can change its color, font size, etc. from here. Okay, there are different types of fonts available. Then you can bold it, italics, underline, change the color of the font. That things are there. Then if you want, this is the link. This is the link of university. If you type in this way, you can add an external link here by selecting the university address, website address. And you can add university website address here, your result. Okay, just leave it. Any website address. Okay, select, and you can select this window and can add a link here in this way. Then what will happen is that, while presenting this post, if a student click on this link, it will directly leads to university website. Or any website you can add like this, and this is the area to insert an image. Inserting an image from your mobile phone is possible now. These are the photos available in my mobile gallery. These photos are directly available in Blogger because of the link between my mobile phone to this Blogger through this email ID. Okay, if I click on this and click on this add selected, the photo from my mobile is directly attached to this blog. Or if you want to add a video, just click this icon. There are several other ways to add photos other than your mobile phone. You can directly take a picture from the webcam and add here. Or you can add a Google album archive. Or from this blog itself you can use. Or otherwise you can upload a photo from your laptop. There are several ways to add photos to your mobile phones. Okay. So your blog. Then if you want to add one video, again, there are different ways. You can directly upload a video to this blog, but it will take much time to upload a video. So don't go for that. In my request is that upload the video in YouTube. Then from YouTube, you can add the video. Here, you can search for the video in your channel or using the title of your, the address of your video, you can select it. And select a particular video, select it to add here. Then it will be directly played here. Then you can add special characters, you can align text. In that way, several things are there. After doing all these things, click publish. Then we can watch how this blog appears now. And this is the blog, this is the tcr.blogspot.com. And this is the layout of this blog. Okay. Test blog, okay. Yeah. This is the link of university. While clicking the link, the student will move to the university website, directly move to the university website. Or you can play the video directly from this platform. So you just clicking here, the video will be...
In order to create Google Classroom.
In this way, you can play directly the video here. And you can add collaborators here. And I request any of you to try this, act like a collaborator here. I will invite you right now. Then you can add tabs here. Here, home, Calicut University. Again, you can add mini tags. How to add tags, that is the second thing. This is the creation of first thing, creation of a new post. And this leave these two things, statistics and comments. In statistics, you can see how many view for this particular page and which from which area of the world your audience are. Such things are there. Then comments means what are the comments for the post you shared. And this is earning means you can make this blog into a passion, into profit, because with the help of this blogger, you can earn money as similar in YouTube also based on the ad clicks. Google will give you some advertisement, and using that advertisement, you can make money from your blog. Then this is the next one, pages. This is the area of our interest. Here I can create a new page with showing about me, or please contact, or about us. In that way, we can add something about us. Yeah. Then here we can add image of a college, exactly similar to a post. All the things can be possible. You can add image, you can add video, or you can add a text. You can add anything about us. You can type address, you can give a Google map, you can give a Google form. Anything you can give, type directly here. Okay, right? After creating this, just click on this publish button. It will not make any change in the blog. We create a about us, but it will not display it anywhere else. But again, go back and go to the next item, layout. Layout. In layout, there is a one important thing to be added. Usually, it is not added by default. And this is the important thing, pages gadget. Instead of this, there is a blue letter like add a gadget. Here, usually in a normal blog, there's a thing that add a gadget. Click on add a gadget and click on pages. There's a red icon and its name is pages. Yeah, this is the pages. Click on this page and it will activate like this, pages, and just try to edit it. Yeah, here about us is here. This is the page I just created. It is not now displayed on my blog. So I click on this, then click save. Then what will happen is that in the blog itself, right side of the Calicut University, a new tag will be appeared about us. If you click on this page, it will lead to that particular page. I typed blah 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 there. Okay, right. In that way, you can add pages and layout. You can use the layout for many other things. Okay. You can search for many other things regarding layout. Then theme. You can change the theme of the blog by clicking the theme button. And now this is an old fashioned blog editing window. Now the blog editing window is changed drastically, and you can view the new view by clicking this particular icon. This is a classic version. It will not be there for a particular period of time. Then you can change this theme, or you can customize this theme. Just click on the customize button. Here you can change the background of the blog, or you can change the color of the blog with single click. See, in a single click, I can change the color of all the letters. Yeah. Otherwise, you can change by part and part. You can change the width of the whole width of the blog. You can change the layout. There is two bars on the two sides, or one bar on the right side, or one bar on the left side. In that way, there are so many things are there. Then in advanced section, you can change each font and each color of each part. Such things are possible in blog. That is, the custom view of a blog can be drastically changed into a website. That is advantage. You can make it exactly like a website. Then, and it is unlimited. So this is the best option for teachers to create their personal websites. That's my opinion. Then if you like to use this platform, and just watch my YouTube channel. There are many other options there. I would like to demonstrate one more thing. That is the only thing we need to do with using HTML language. There is no need of studying HTML language to create a website like this. But if you know a little knowledge, you can make it more interesting. Before going to that, I will demonstrate again my college blog here, in which our certificate programs are there in verify certificates. If I click on the verify certificate, there is a scrolling sentence is there. This is the last faculty development program conducted in our college. And a link to this page is displayed in every certificate. So if anyone wanted to verify the certificate is original or not, they can just scan the QR code and it will lead to this page. And they can click on this particular link, whether their name and the certificate ID is there. And it is updated every 5 minutes. It is automatically updated every 5 minutes. If it is a genuine participant of the FDP, their name and their certificate ID will be there. Okay. In that way, anyone can verify their certificate. It is not the thing I want to demonstrate. Here, the scrolling option, how to make the sentence scroll through a blog post. That is important thing here. That is the only thing we have to make using with the help of what is called HTML language. Here, not much thing you have to learn regarding this HTML language. In this home page, I make one sentence. This link, this is the link of university. I want to scroll through this window. I want scroll this link through the window. In order to make such change, I do one thing in the blog post. In the first blog post, this is the first blog post where the sentence is there. This is the link of university. And actually, this is the custom view of a blog post. We can change the custom view into HTML view. Whatever I added to this page can be converted into HTML language with a single click here. This is the area, HTML. Just click here. And this is the HTML code of that particular page. And we can change only one thing here. There is a sentence inside these small sentence. There is a sentence known as this is the link of university. This is the link of university. Such a sentence is here. Can you read this? Okay. Just in front of this sentence, I made a small change, and that is a code known as not a marquee code. Marquee HTML language. Any HTML codes are put in less than, greater than, symbol. So for that purpose, I put less than symbol and type marquee, marquee, and then close the tag, but it should be in small letters. Marquee. UEE. Is it correct? Marquee. Yeah. That is correct. Then close the tag, mark you. That is right. Again, after the sentence, again put that code. But in front of the sentence, in the quote, there should be a slash. M-A-R-Q-U-E-E. Yes, this is the code. I will show the code in a Zoom manner. I'll copy that code and I just click on update. If the code is accepted, it is accepted, then just go here and refresh the page and search what is happening here. The sentence scroll through the page. This is the university link. It is the link of university. The sentence is scroll through the window. And what is the code? And I will show the code here. Yeah, this is the code. Mark you. Is it visible for all? I think. Mark you. This is the only code I added. M-A-R-Q-U-E-E. In a less than greater than symbol. And this is the part. And here also add mark you, but there is a slash. And this is the code to make that word scroll through the window. Okay, in that way you can make add beauty to your blog. Okay, next thing, collaboration. How to add collaborators in your blog? You can invite someone trying to present. I think Srija TS. Okay, now I think my screen is again visible. Please check whether my screen is visible or not.
No, sir, not yet. Again, somebody made the mistake of presenting. Mrs. Payal Lal, yeah, Pyare Lal, please stop presenting. Yeah, thank you. Sajan, sir.
Yeah, okay, again, I will.
Yes, please. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay. Now, Okay. Now go to settings. In order to collaborate other contributors to this blog, just click on this settings button. Here, there are so many options. You can change the title of the blog. You can change the description of the blog. You can even change the address of the blog. gcttcr.blogspot.com can be changed, but only if it is available. Okay. Then these are the contributors of this blog. Many of them are admin. Many of them are admin. Some of them are authors. Okay. I invite some of you to add as authors here. What is the procedure for that? Click on add author. Okay. Only an admin can do this, and type the name, type the email address of others here. For example, if I invite Sedu Esnad, my friend, to join this blog. Okay, her email address is here, seduesnad@gmail.com. Click invite. If she accepted this invitation, she can join here as author. Then after joining here, I can convert her to admin too. And this is the method to add collaborators to this blog. And after adding collaborators, anyone, all the admins have the equal right to add, edit, make changing the theme, etc. on this blog. And this is the fantastic site to create your e-content. So many teachers create e-content during this using this blog. I created a blog on the Techno Search. here I used a blog to disseminate the knowledge on e-teaching using this blog. Similarly, anyone can create a blog using, I think one more interesting blog is there created by a college teacher. And he collaborated with me. Yeah, this is another blog of me on educational statistics. I think not much material is here, yet this is how to create Mann-Whitney U-test. It is created in 2018. Okay, and you can create this such blog, and you can give just this address to any student other than your college. What I mean, in your college, you can give your Moodle, Google Classroom, or Edmodo, anything like that. But for the students of other colleges, if you need your material, this is the easiest way. My notes and PDF presentations are here. In that way, they can access my materials. See, all these are materials compiled by me. PowerPoint, Word file, so many topics are there. With the help of only this address edn.stat.blogspot.com. Any student in MEd can access this material. This is the advantage of creating a blog. I think this is enough for now regarding our topic, today's topic. And I would like to give feedbacks and can answer to some questions which may be available in YouTube chat as well as our Google chat. I think some of the topics are finished, and regarding the bookmarking tools, Wakelet and Linktree, these are simple tools. You can just search for Linktree. It helps you to compile. If you have a blog, you have a Google site, you have a YouTube channel, you have several materials in several places. And if you like to combine all these things into a single place, that is known as bookmarking sites. The one of the famous bookmarking site is Linktree. Just create an account in Linktree, and you can compile all those things into a beautiful form. Here I would like to log in, and I can demonstrate, I think. Yeah. My credentials are already stored there, so it is easy. The address, blog is there, my e-learning for teaching, my YouTube channel, all are compiled into a single form like this in a mobile. It is so easy to observe. That is advantage. And the address for this blog is only this one. I can share this link, copy link, and I can share this link in the chat with a single address. Like this, with a single address like this, anyone can watch my all materials on online from different platforms. It are those are combined into a single address, and you can add many more using this platform, Linktree. Linktree is the site. I think that's enough for today, and you can have some questions and you can ask to me. If possible, and if I know the answer, I can. Otherwise, I will search and answer later in using my YouTube channel. Okay, sir, please read some questions on the chat box. Or
hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I'll just read out a few questions. Sir, Surya Subhash has come up with a question on, are there any simple tools to draw biochemical pathways?
Actually, that is a technical question. I am not actually not aware of a specific biochemical pathway drawing tools, but there is a tool known as OpenBoard, but I don't know whether it is useful for you. Where you can use your mouse as a pen to draw anything, then I think biochemical pathway needs some specific symbols like hexagons or benzene rings, etc. I don't know, it is I don't think it is possible to draw all those things using that tool, but in Android phone you please just search in Play Store to for such tools. It may be available here. This is the open board, the tool named as open board. Here you can draw anything, and or you can use the tools from here in this area to draw things, and you can record also. You can record this window using this podcast. If it is enough, it's good. Otherwise, you have to go for, then here in application, you can take compass as a tool. And using the compass tool, you can draw, where it is. Yeah, in this, you can draw circles. And that way you can use this tool. I think this screen is not visible. Sorry. Yes, sir.
The screen is still not visible.
Yeah. Now it is okay. This is a tool known as Open Board. Using this board, open board, using your mouse itself, you can draw, or you can take some tools from here, protractor, a triangle, rulers, etc. are there, and using the tool, you can draw anything on the board. I think.
But is this a computer based tool or a mobile based tool?
It is computer based. Right. It is only for Windows. In computer, in mobile phone, there is an application known as Blackboard. Using Blackboard, you can draw anything.
Dr. Gopal Reddy wants to know if there is OBS software available for mobile.
No, it is not possible in mobile. In mobile phone, you go for AZ screen recorder, X recorder.
Pardon, sir. The name, please.
AZ screen recorder,
okay,
or DU recorder. DU recorder or X recorder.
Okay,
see, this is my mobile phone in which I used to record the screen using X recorder now, or some inbuilt recorders are there in modern mobiles. In my mobile, there is a screen recorder on the top right side. List, you can see that screen recorder is there, or you can use it. Otherwise, go for X recorder. After opening X recorder, it can be used similar to this OBS screen recorder, because not all the features. You can switch on the camera. Yeah, my camera is now here, and you can open a PowerPoint. After opening the PowerPoint, PowerPoint on intelligence, you can start presenting by clicking the slideshow. Yeah. Now, just again touch on this icon and click on. Yeah. My voice is audible now.
Yes, sir. You're audible, sir.
Okay. This is my mobile screen now. You can just touch here and start recording by clicking the red button. And just look into your camera and explain. In Unit 3, we have to learn this and these things. And the first topic is learn a difference in intelligence and creativity. Okay, in that way, you create your video and just stop recording, and you can share directly into YouTube. This is the best application for mobile phone. X recorder. Okay, any questions?
Okay, sir.
Read other question. Second
yes,
question.
Sir. Yeah. Sir, can a rubric, Syed Obaid Qureshi has asked, can a rubric automatically check assignments in Nomio?
Yeah. If it is a single click answer, a rubric can be used in Binomio.
Okay, sir. Kavita ma'am has asked, is there no Google Lens in our phone? We can download the app called text scanner?
Okay, you can use text scanner. Otherwise, you can go for Google Lens itself. You can directly search for Google Lens in Play Store, and you can install it as a separate application other than Google Photo. Actually, in Google Photo, Google Lens is attached, but only in new mobiles, new Android versions. In old versions, you have to install Google Lens separately.
Okay, sir. Sir Rajeshwari Prasad, ma'am, has asked, while adding participants in Nomio, whether Excel sheet is used only for bulk adding or single participants?
Okay, you can add single participants one by one without using any Google Sheets. You can directly type their name, email ID, user ID there. Otherwise, you have to use this comma separated text, CSV text. Okay.
Okay, sir. Sir, one more question from Priya. She has asked, what is it, how to add videos to our blogs?
It is so simple. I already demonstrated that. In a post, I think my screen, mobile screen is here. I want to change. Here. I already demonstrated it. While creating a new post or an existing post, just click on the video icon here. Before Man Whitney U-test, I want to demonstrate one video. If I would like to add one video, just click on this video icon. Okay, that's all. Then from YouTube, or you can directly upload, or from my YouTube video. My YouTube video from my channel, I can directly add one video. There's no video regarding this particular topic. That's the problem. Man Whitney. I search for Man With Me in YouTube, and I add any one video you can add. Here, how to perform Man With Me U-test by hand. This video I would like to add. Click on this and click on select. Yeah, that video is added. That's all. Then click on update. Okay.
Okay, sir. Sir, Professor Balusheri is of the doubt whether we can record Zoom class using X recorder.
Actually, there is a problem that not with the Zoom. In Zoom, you can record using X recorder or DU recorder, no problem. But in Google Meet, it is not possible because it record only the video, not the sound of the meeting.
Okay, sir. Okay. Right. So one last request from Surya Subhash, who has asked, can you demonstrate the use of OpenShot editing?
Yeah, but I think now my screen is visible to you, I think.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. This is OpenShot video editor. Just double click it because this is a heavy application, OpenShot video editor. In many computer, while installing this OpenShot video, any video editor, it say that your computer not have a video graphic board. Usually, we are not not bothered about a graphic board while purchasing a laptop. That's also happens to me also. While installing this OpenShot video editor, it will search for the physical facilities available in the computer and say that my graphic board is not so not short enough to support video editing, but I use this application somehow for this purpose. Okay, I will demonstrate. It will switch on right now. Yeah. Kdel Live require more memory than this, more graphic memory than this. There is another process than CPU. GPU is there in our laptop, graphic processing unit. It should be strong enough for all this purpose. Okay. Now this is the starting window of this OpenShot video editor. Just click on this plus button. Here there is a plus button. Is it visible, sir?
Sir, it is visible, sir.
Okay. Just open the video and select the video we just created in the last session. Yeah, this is the video. Select the video. And it will be there. And just click and drag it into the track. Okay, put it there. And just try to play it.
Start recording.
And this is okay. The initial stage. I want to remove all those things. Just move this. Yeah. I think this is the starting area. See, this is the starting area of the video.
You can search for participant list.
Not here. Yeah, not here. Yes, this is a full view. All other things are the preliminary thing I can create it. I want to remove this much area from my video. Just right click here on this icon. Just right click here. Slice all. Keep both side or keep right side. I need keep right side. Then the left side is removed. I can just click and drag it here. And this is an easy way to remove the unwanted area from our. Yeah, this is the end of this video. I just click here and right click and slice, keep left side. Okay, then this is the area. Now I want to add one audio clip. Just click on this, just click on again this plus button and search for any good audio files. Okay, there is a good audio files of one raga. File is there. I add this into here. I want to reduce the screen, then only I can demonstrate all those things. Yeah, here this is a file. I will place this file here. Then I am trying to play this video file again.
Now make a,
then background music is added.
Change in the white,
but its sound is more. I want to reduce the sound. Click on volume. Entire clip to reduce to percentage 20. Okay, now its sound is reduced.
Please watch manually. Yeah. Here.
Now music is more than my video, so I want to remove the end of this music clip. Again, just right click, slice, keep on left side. So now it is okay. Now the project preparation is over. Now I want to export, and this is the button to export video. Exporting the video. Combining these things together into MP4 format, and it is in HD quality into a particular folder. It is as test video. I want to export, and this process may take hours based on your GPU. See, now only 2.26 to 37% is completed. And this is a basic thing regarding OpenShot video edit. Only basic things. Okay, I think it's enough. Sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're very, very comprehensively explained the whole thing.
Okay.
Sir, the rest are appreciation for the time and effort that you have taken, and yes, they are all thank you and appreciations for you. I hope we can stop there, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you for your patient listening. Many participants are still there in this late evening. Now we sit together for many days. Then my request, my last assignment for you, just try to create a good blog with a good video of you. A blog with a good video. So you have to create a video and upload your blog, and just give the blog address segment list they may provide. Okay, with that, we can stop here. I thank all of the participants, and I thank Benedict Sir, the principal of RTFLS Training College, and other colleagues of him in the college, Laji Sir, and the teacher, and all participants gathered here. I thank very much. I think I can continue this work. And if you in your college you need a class like this, please contact me. If I time permit, I will available to handle the sessions. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the wonderful session. Thanks to all the participants for being with us for all the 3 days. Just like yesterday, we will paste the assignments given by Dr. Sajan onto the four groups that we had created, and only after the submission of the assignments will we close the groups. Thank you very much.
Okay, may I leave, sir?
Yes, sir. A very good evening to you. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, thank you.
हेलो बेनेडिक्ट सर है, लाजी सर, आंसी टीचर,
हाँ सरे,
हाँ सरे, नमन अच्छा है उनको आंसी इनी एंड एंड द मटे वाले एंड एंड फीलिंग या बिलाड़ी वाला उनको आंसी,
उनको सरे,
एंड एंड फीडबैक फीलिंग या हमारे वाले जिया नंदा,
आ फीडबैक फॉर्म उनको सरे